like wide out angles and the dialogue, which made it very clear that you were watching a movie again. That's just like the most recurring theme in all of his movies. It's just so obvious that you're watching a movie that you just can't help but to laugh. So I really enjoyed this one as well, Kill Bill Volume 1. And you know, I also love Kill Bill Volume 2, but you know, because it's just kind of like a play on a Volume 1, I didn't really want to rank it, you know, because they're more or less the same to me. Last up on my list is, of course, the one and only Pulp Fiction. Now, you might be surprised that it's number 3 on my list, but it was only because, like, the storyline was kind of, like, all over the place, and if you've ever seen this movie, there are some weird, weird scenes in this one, guys. Like, if you see it, you'll know exactly what I mean. And his films are so timeless and iconic that even though this movie came out in 1994, I feel like I'd be spoiling something to you if I ever, like, if I said anything. This film again came out in 1994. It currently holds a 92% on Rotten Tomatoes. And again, very lengthy, 2 hours and 58 minutes long. Classic Tarantino film. And this one was cool because it gained Quentin global attention and worldwide attention. You know, before then he was doing kind of like smaller projects like Reservoir Dogs and Jackie Brown. Exposed to John Travolta. I know he's known for like Footloose and all of those like kind of like pretty boy roles and stuff like that. So I mean, he's a very talented actor, and he's married to like one of the most beautiful women I've ever seen, Kelly Preston. She's in that movie Twins with Arnold Schwarzenegger and Danny DeVito. So shout out. And yeah, that's my third and final favorite movie by Quentin Tarantino. Now you might be surprised that there's only those are the only three that really connect with me. Of course, I love some of the other movies he's done, and he said he's only gonna make 10 films. So this 9th one is coming out. Once Upon a Time in Hollywood comes out next week, July 26th. Again, as I mentioned in my last video, it's almost like a national holiday at this point for me. Like, I've been waiting for this since the teaser trailer came out, and even before then, when I was just, you know, doing research online, like last year. Saw that Brad Pitt and Leonardo DiCaprio were filming in LA, so that's kind of cool because, believe it or not, most films don't actually get made in LA, even though like Los Angeles is the hub for movie making. A lot of films don't get made there. And another great fact is, there's no CGI in this movie. They recreated the entire, you know, like dynamic and feel of the 1960s. Yeah, 60s. It wasn't 50s. Yeah, I think it was. This one was set in the 60s because it talks about the murders that happened in LA, and I know Cliff Booth, and which is Leo's character, or is that Bradford? I don't know, I'm getting lost, but yeah, it's gonna be a great movie. I'm very excited about it, looking forward to it. As you can see, I'm stumbling over my words just talking about it, because man, I've been waiting for this for a long, long time. I'm looking forward to it, and this will actually be my first time seeing theaters. Because like I mentioned, I've really only been into films and, you know, movie making since I was 18, and I'm only 20 now, so only 2 years really. And that was because, just a quick backstory, during my freshman year in college, I had a professor who was actually a former director, and he showed us like classic films like Bonnie and Clyde and Singing in the Rain, all those movies, and it just really exposed me to just this entire world of excellence, I guess. Like, I loved it so much, so that's what really got me inspired and just very interested and motivated to watch these films and really connect and understand it. But that's the beauty of, like, I guess going to like a liberal arts school, I guess, is like you're forced to be around creative minds. Sorry if you hear a dog in the background, but yeah, great film. But just to heap on some of the other films that I didn't mention in this film ranking, I liked Inglourious Basterds. Like I said, the plot was a little bit all over the place. It was cool how he kind of rewrote history and put his own spin on it. Could be misconstrued as a little bit disrespectful, in my opinion, but I mean, like I said, he makes it very obvious is Quentin Tarantino week. Like, I can't wait. I'm super excited, man. So that's been it for this one, guys. Like I said, I'm assuming that most people who are subscribed to this channel so far, you guys like the NBA content. So I'll probably be dropping a best NBA duos of all time video probably either Monday or Tuesday. So look forward to that. But I'll still be dropping videos on Brad Pitt and Leonardo DiCaprio and talking about their filmography this week. So if you're a film head like me, look forward to that. So with that being said, guys, I'm out. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. And oh, before I go, I don't know if he's going to watch this, but shout out to Michael D'Angelo. He left a comment on one of my videos, and it really